Hello students, today let us deal with the topic Advertising and Visual Publicity. Advertising is a very common term known and used by many people almost every day. In every media and on every service like trash box, sky, walls, public urinals, etc., advertisements of many products are seen. It has become a part of human life as a macro concept representing the entire advertising industry and micro managerial concept standing for a specific managerial function of any organization intending to send information to other members of the society. The term advertising has been derived from the original Latin word advertere, which means to turn the attention. Every piece of advertising turns the attention of the readers or the listeners or the viewers or the onlookers towards a product or a service or an idea. Hence, as explained by Sontecki, anything that turns the attention to an article or a service or an idea might well be called as advertising. According to C.H. Sanch and V. Freiberger, advertising is multidimensional, that is, a powerful marketing tool, a component of economic system, a means of financing the mass media, a social institution, an art form, an instrument of business management, a field of employment, and a paying profession. According to Encyclopedia Britannica, advertising is a form of communication intended to promote the rate of product or service, to influence public opinion, to gain political support, or to advance a particular cause. According to American Market Association, advertising is any paid form of non-personal presentation of ideas, goods or services by an identified sponsor. However, advertising can finally be understood as mass communication as well as market communication process of influencing and convincing the customers or prospects to buy products or services with increased satisfaction to the customer and profits to the producer. Here, let me provide you few definitions of advertising communication. According to Arins, advertising is the non-personal communication of information usually paid for and persuasive in nature about products or ideas by identified sponsor through various media. And according to Black and Black, advertising is any paid form of non-personal communication about an organization, product, service or idea from an identified sponsor. And according to Beard, Ingram and Lafforgi, advertising is the element of the market communication process that is non-personal, paid for an identified sponsor and disseminated through channels of mass communication to promote the adoption of goods, services, persons or ideas. Therefore, advertising can be concluded as the broad and direct market communication that introduces the brand to the public, educates about products and services, prompts people with an interest to take action, and provides urgency when conveyed special promotions. It is also a public mode of communication as it gets communicated simultaneously to a large number of people. Advertising was in use 2000 years ago. Initially, cries and signs were used to carry information for goods and services consisting of illustrations of symbols of the products advertised. The rise in advertising came after the development of printing and signs were replaced by written words or messages. Thus, in Industrial Revolution, advertising was evolved as a market communication tool and rapidly got professionalization. Advertising has become the most visible marketing tool to transmit messages through effective media. It has become paid sponsoring activity and non-personal communication directed at mass audience. Advertising has become mass communication process where the advertiser is the source who transmits the messages, which passes through an appropriate medium like press, TV, radio, magazines, etc., which is received by large number of people. Now, let us discuss about few milestones in advertising. Initially, prior to 5th century, hide criers and wall signs were used in advertising. Human voice, executed signs and placards were used during 5th to 8th century. Free samples were used during 9th to 15th century. And in 1438, printed materials, posters, handbills, newspapers, etc. were used. During 16th to 17th century, newsletters to newsbooks to newspapers of present type were used. During 18th to 19th century, magazine advertising, promotional advertising, window displays, fairs, etc. have been used. During 20th century, radio, TV, traveling display, neon signs, skywriting, etc. were used. In 21st century, we are using digital signage and online advertising. The marketing communication process is sender, encoding, transmission device, decoding, receiver process, which is a part of any advertising or marketing program. Encoding the message is the second step in communication process, which takes a creative idea and transforms into attention-getting advertisement designed for various media such as television, radio, magazines and others. Messages travel to audience through various transmissions. The third stage of the marketing communication process occurs when a channel or medium delivers the message. Decoding occurs when the message reaches one or more of the receiver senses. Consumers both hear and see television ads. Effective communication to a specific target audience is the key to make advertisements stand out and get results. Few important points. To affect audience. Successful communication in an advertisement involves focusing on a certain audience with information that meets this group's needs. There are three main reactions that a good ad can trigger from these intended viewers. Emotions of the audience, that is, feel something because of the message. Thinking about what the advertisement is saying. And action in terms of decision on buying the product or service. Next, communication through branding. According to the American Market Association, branding is defined by a name, sign or symbol which is designed to identify a seller's goods or services. The entire effort is to convince consumers that it is the only product available to meet their needs. Advertising communication provides an opportunity to deliver a clear message, reflect credibility, connect with the consumer emotionally, motivate the buyer and build loyalty. Next, to stimulate purchasing behavior. By spending time on research, planning and developing a brand, one can stimulate a feel of connection in the mind of the consumer with the brand. This in turn instigates and influences the purchasing behavior in a way that benefits the company. To sustain emotions of the consumer. Emotion is a powerful in a brand because it is an effective way to connect with an audience. Brands that inspire an emotional response are able to draw the attention of the consumer and a successful following towards the company. If the consumer feels good of the product, he or she will be a sustainable consumer of the product. This can be achieved by constant touch and continuous contact. Advertising communication is the only means of attaining it. Now, let's deal with objectives of advertising communication. Objectives include to make public attitudes more favorable to a particular product, to build an image of the product, to get across the idea of a unique product, to reduce existing negative attitudes, to keep building loyalty, to establish the brand and position it in a particular way to convey the idea that the product is value for money, to say how much people like the product. Initially, let us see the effect on prices. Some advertised products do cost more than unadvertised products, but the vice versa is also true. But if there is more competition in the market for those products, the prices have to come down. For example, canned juices from various brands. Some professionals like chartered accountants and doctors are not allowed to advertise. Like this, some products do not advertise much and even their prices are high, but they are still leaders in market as they have their brand name. Effect on consumer demand and choices. Even if the product is heavily advertised, it doesn't mean that the demand or say consumption rates will also increase. The product has to be different with better quality and more variety than others. For example, cornflakes have variety of flavors with different ranges to offer for different age groups. And for people who want to lose weight, gives consumers different choices to select from. Effect on business cycle. Advertising no doubt helps in employing more number of people. It increases the payrolls of people working in this field. And also, it helps collecting more revenues for sellers, which they use for betterment of products and services. But there are some bad effects of advertisements on business cycle also. Sometimes, consumer may find the foreign product better than going for the national brand. This will definitely affect the production, which may in turn affect the GDP of the country. The economic aspects are supported by the abundance principle, which says producing more products and services than the consumption rate, which helps firstly keeping consumers informed about the options they have, and secondly helps sellers to play in healthy and competitive atmosphere with their self-interest. There are some negative as well as positive aspects of advertising on the social ground. They are as follows. Deception in advertising. The relation between the buyers and sellers is maintained if the buyers are satisfied with what they saw in advertisement and what they got after buying that product. If sellers shows a false or deceptive image and an exaggerated image of the product in the advertisement, then the relationship between the seller and the buyers can't be healthy. These problems can be overcome if the sellers keep their ads clean and displays right image of the product. The subliminal advertising. Capturing the minds of the consumers is the main intention of these ads. The ads are made in such a way that the consumers don't even realize that the ad has made an impact on their minds, and this results in buying the product which they don't even need. But all ads don't impress all consumers at all times, because majority of consumers buy products on basis of the price and needs. Effect on our social system. The advertisers use puffing tactics, endorsements from celebrities, and play emotionally, which makes ads so powerful that the consumers, like helpless preys, buy those products. These ads make poor people buy products which they can't afford. People picking up bad habits like smoking and drinking and buy products just because their favorite actor endorsed their product. This affects the whole society and losses of values of our own selves. Here, I'll provide you few positive and negative impacts of advertising. Positive effects: public service advertisements, social benefits, economic benefits, and choice. Negative impacts of advertising: misrepresentation, unrealistic expectations, false images, negative impact on children. Offensiveness. Some ads are so offensive that they are not acceptable by the buyers. For example, the ads of jeans show girls wearing very less clothes and making a sex appeal. These kinds of ads are irrelevant to the actual product. There are some ads which are educative and now accepted by the people. For example, earlier ads giving information about birth control pills was considered offensive. But now, the same ads are considered educative and important. Socio-economic effects of advertising. NCAER, National Council of Applied Economic Research, has recently conducted the study on socio-economic effects of advertising. The salient findings are whether advertising is good or bad. It is an outcome of the complex interaction between product kind, market structure and consumer behavior. There is a rural-urban divide about the influence of advertising on buying. 16% from rural area are influenced to buy frequently and buy always products they do not need really. The corresponding urban figure is 25%. 19% rural respondents think ads to be misleading as against 48% in urban area. 75% from both rural and urban area finds ads useful to them and to their family. Salaried people showed a higher belief about information value of ads. Recall of ads is generally higher in urban areas. There is strong objection to blatant sex appeal. Illiterates outnumber literates in such objections. 77% manufacturers agreed that ads occasionally or frequently exploit sex. Opinion leaders are also critical in such ads. Manufacturers feel that there exists a cultural gap between ad professionals and real India. Journalists or economists felt that ad professionals have a superficial knowledge of the country. They also have a negative view of societal influence of advertising. Commercial advertising is a form of communication with the intention of promoting the sale of a particular product attached to a brand. Branding is an essential aspect of commercial advertising. It is used to distinguish the product from the similar products of the market. Commercial advertising takes place in the form of print and electronic media. Print media is most static and electronic media often takes the form of a story or incident depicted in a short-term frame. The intention is to highlight the utility of the brand and the values associated with its use. Modern days advertising involves endorsement by celebrities as well. Commercial advertising mostly uses mass multimedia to increase the product branding through the use of large-scale advertising. Companies use commercials to reach those who view television shows or watch videos on TV or online because it is easy to turn a channel, skip through recorded commercial, or close a web browser. Those who make commercial must try to make their advertisements as compelling as possible. Advertisers employ a handful of techniques to reach target audiences and promote products. Here, I'll provide you few techniques of commercial advertising. Demographic positioning. Demographic positioning occurs in commercials when the advertiser makes it clear that the company is mainly trying to reach a certain audience. This audience can vary depending on age, gender, wealth, educational level, and ethnicity. Examples of this type of advertising can be found in DirecTV's Sunday ticket commercials that promote football packages to a large male audience. Dramatic conflict. Commercials that have some kind of dramatic conflict to be resolved may capture the interest of viewers. The conflict could be as simple as a mother arguing with the teenager daughter or a mailman working in a snowstorm. Advertisers often create heroes for whom viewers can root in commercials with dramatic conflict. A famous dramatic conflict commercial appeared in the 1980s in the Partnership for a Drug-Free America commercial, during which a child tells his questioning father, "I learned it by watching you," when asked about how he found out about drugs. Emotion. There are certain situations and ideas that advertisers rely on to create an emotional response among viewers. This includes family memories, weddings, funerals, and natural disasters. The stronger the emotion a commercial evokes, the more likely a person is to watch it. Cottons, the fabric of our lives. Campaign focuses on life events and how cotton is involved in them. Big exaggerations. A small exaggeration in a commercial might be viewed as a lie, but a large exaggeration is more often viewed as a comedic element and an attention grabber. One method associated with this technique involves exaggerating the visual element but understanding the copy or vice versa. An example of an exaggerated commercial can be found in the Old Spice campaign that includes a man log rolling, building a kitchen with one hand, baking a cake, and diving into a hot tub in less than 30 seconds. Interesting characters. Many companies have mascots or spokespersons who represent them in commercials. Some of these are celebrities or athletes, others are characters in the advertising agency makes up to garner interest in a product or service. Geico's caveman and gecko mascots are two examples of interesting characters. Promise benefits. Commercials often make promises that a person will benefit from using the product or service being promoted. These benefits could include assistance with physical ailments, more friends, a lifetime guarantee, or an easier life. Effective advertisers will focus on specific benefits rather than general ones. For example, Fiber One commercials focus on the benefits of eating fiber with your breakfast. Media messages designed to educate or motivate public to engage in voluntary social activity such as community service, energy conservation, recycling refers to a developmental advertising. The advertising industry was never seen as a market for comfort or self-esteem. Much of it is predicated on pointing out its audience's shortcomings so that it can offer us solutions to fix them. But there's an entire genre that's dedicated to promote social causes, and these are executed with the same level of creativity and innovation. Here, few examples of developmental advertising are provided. So students, with this, I conclude the topic, advertising and visual publicity. Do you have any questions?
Ma'am, I have a question. How is the relation between buyers and sellers maintained?
I can say the relation between the buyers and sellers is maintained if the buyers are satisfied with what they saw in advertisement and what they got after buying that product. If seller shows a false or deceptive image and an exaggerated image of the product in the advertisement, then the relationship between them can't be healthy. These problems can be overcome if the seller keeps their ads clean and displays right image of the product. Any more questions? Okay, fine. With this, I conclude the topic, advertising and visual publicity. Thank you.